Okay. So my practice for my presentation I have tomorrow. It's a presentation on anarchy. And what I was trying to do is see if you could really learn anything from a book that's useful surrounding the subject of anarchy. And to find that a little bit clearer, academia's definition of anarchy was what I was really looking for. So one of my first stops in my research was I went back to the first time I ever remember hearing anarchy and like conceptualizing it, and it was from a TV show called Sons of Anarchy. Kurt Sutter's the writer of that show, and he was quoting Emma Goldman, and the quote goes something like this: "Anarchism stands for the liberation of the human mind from the domination of religion and liberation of the human body from the coercion of property, liberation from the shackles and restraints of government. It stands for social order based on the free grouping of individuals." And so that was good and great, and I kind of thought about that, but not really, and now I'm thinking about it, which is lovely. And so to tie that in, Kurt kind of does a better job than I'm ever going to be able to do. So in his words, "The concept was pure and simple, true. It inspired me, lit a rebellious fire, but ultimately I learned the lesson that Goldman and Pradon and the others learned, that true freedom requires sacrifice and pain. Most human beings only think they want freedom. In truth, they yearn for the bondage of social order, rigid laws, and materialism. The only freedom man really wants is the freedom to be comfortable." And with that, we're going to turn it over to Monty Python and the quest for the Holy Grail in a little clip. Here we go.
Not from some farcical aquatic ceremony.
Be quiet!
But you can't expect to wield supreme executive power just because some watery tart threw a sword at you.
Shut up!
If I went round saying I was an emperor just because some moistened bint had lugged a scimitar at me, they'd put me away.
Shut up, will you? Shut up!
Ah, now we see the violence inherent in the system.
Shut up!
Oh, come and see the violence inherent in the system! Help, help! I'm being repressed,
bloody peasant!
Oh, what a giveaway. Do you hear that? Do you hear that, eh? That's what I'm on about. Do you see him repressing me? You saw it, didn't you?
Yeah, we all seen it. Oppression, great. So the reason why I showed that video is it leads into one of the cool things I did find, which is an anarcho-syndicalism, which in Nam's words is alternative institutions that are more free and just, moving onto a world of free association, worker... communities that are controlling their own institutions. Community of interest and commitment. Example would be Mondragon in Spain. It is a worker co-op that employs 80,000 people and is a major force in the financial industry, in finance industry and distribution. Has a university research and development center, a seventh largest economic group in Spain. Recently, the employees cut their own wages 8% to keep everyone working and also forego the Christmas bonus equal to a month's salary. So what is my conclusion? I conclude that anarchy in its purest form sets about to destroy the state and capitalism. In an effort to free man of his perceived bondages. Anarchy allows anyone to be a critical thinker, capable of self-sufficiency, self-expression, and self-grouping. So how does this all relate to the broader theme of alternatives that we have been studying? To tie it all together, I feel that we need to borrow from other eras, anarchist political stances and philosophies to come up with an alternative within anarchy, a hybrid, if you will. The A in this symbol for anarchy stands for the meaning of anarchy, which is to be free of rulers. But the circle represents the order part. I conclude that maybe the multitude or the flesh of the flesh should be incorporated into anarchy on a more intellectual, profound level. Stealing, copying, incorporating a symbol I've seen around campus a lot is the anarchy A with a heart instead of a circle. I thought, what do they mean by this? What is this new symbol representing? In my warped mind, I figured it meant that a new political party is being born and that maybe they're calling it anarchy. The ideals of being a humanist with the structure of anarcho-syndicalism, we admit that the government and corporations aren't leaving anytime soon, that we infiltrate the government, we expose and hold accountable the bullshit rules, regulations, and laws that keep us down and out. We admit that for now the system, the man, has legitimacy, but realize and take responsibility for the fact that the best interests of the multitude have not been at the forefront of the decision-making process, that those in charge had no regard to the economic, social well-being, or future of this planet's peasant population, which is about to become every last one of us. My ideal here is that forming an inclusive political party for those who have given up on traditional institutions that are outdated, outnumbered, and about to be outfoxed.